Let's imagine your mom asked you to bring some chilies while coming back from school, and as usual you forgot. But the particular piece of information that you have to bring chilies was in your mind, so you do not forgot it. So rather it calling it as you forgot it, we will call it as you made a mistake. So why do computers don't make mistake? Why computers don't forgot, or you can say that they do not make mistake while ringing your alarm, while giving you the reminder? We will be talking about this in this video, so stay tuned. Why computers don't forget, and we humans too, because we humans are made up of organic compounds and computers are made up of electricity. I know that computers eat electricity. Computers work on electricity. Considering components of computer, there are many things, but main component which are responsible for the fact that computers don't forget is memory and processor. And as you know, there are two types of memory, RAM and ROM, and the full form of their abbreviation describes them as a piece of shit. So first let's know what they are. Whenever computers indulge themselves in a task, a piece of data is needed in that work and is kept in RAM and others in ROM.
I think you are getting bored, so let's share an incredible fact. Many of us say that human is a very good machine. Human is very good machine. Gods make us very great. So do you know a fact that the current Intel i9 processor, the latest i9 10th generation processor that's currently in the market, is actually 1 million times faster than our brain. What? 1 million times faster than our brain. So why computers actually lag, or you can say that why computers actually cannot take as fast decision as we humans do? Why they cannot respond to reflexes? So the answer is software. Yes, coming back to the point.
So continuing about memory, let's talk about an analogy. Human brain have two types of memory, as still we know, it's temporary and permanent. And yes, you guessed it right, temporary acts as RAM and permanent acts as ROM. Which information we need to place in ROM and which in RAM is easily decided in case of computers rather in brain, because it's difficult. And why it's difficult? Because the information that we need to put in our temporary memory and which in permanent is decided by the subconscious mind. Our subconscious mind never wants our brain to get filled up and let it say, I'm out of memory, you dumbass, by another memory lobe. Okay, that's true. And talking about computer memory, their subconscious mind is actually our conscious mind. Wow. So we store data irrespective of fearing about getting our SSD filled. It's obvious why a body wanna delete his so-called study material folder from his desktop. In computers, data is stored in form of 0 and 1, and in human brain, concepts are similar, but we use neurons. Wait, is it boring? Here's a fact. Whenever you delete a data, it can be a file, it can be a photo, it can be a video, anything. But when actually you delete a data, it's never get deleted actually. The only location of the file at which the data was kept on the drive, on that actual drive, that address is being deleted, not the actual file. And if the file can be easily, retrieved by some softwares known as Recover, until and unless and other information is being replaced on the same disk where that information was kept earlier. And as a matter of fact, again, a single disk which is capable of storing 1 terabyte can store up to 14 times of it, because even if you just replace data or impose data on a drive which actually has another data before, you can actually retrieve both of them by solving some further chemical reactions and other stuff which can be done in industry use only. Wait, how many times I just said actually? leave it. So we were discussing about the memory placements and how our conscious mind actually deletes data from computer. But nowadays computer has an option of which you may enable, but you should not, that it can delete data automatically. Basically, data which is irrelevant is deleted, and from language of computers, irrelevant means not used for a long period of time. So data can be deleted. But in case of humans, the data that is deleted from the brain is segregated on two bases. One is how old it is, and number two is its value in particular being's life. Obviously, first one is directly proportional and second one is indirectly proportional to the value of time the data will be stored in our brain. What? Yes. Alright, so till now we have seen why we forget things. Because our subconscious mind make it do, but that not satisfy us. Nah. So let's discuss something big. Starting with something small, let's imagine once your mother asked you to bring some chilies while coming back from school, and as usual you forgot. And I know that I had asked you to imagine, but I also know that it happens to you every time. So what's this? Actually, you didn't forgot. The information just didn't click during the way back from school about what your mom has asked you to do. Hence, rather it calling as you forgot, we should term this as a mistake. That means you made a mistake. So why computers don't make mistake? Why it didn't forgot to ring the alarm? Why it didn't forgot to send you the reminder? So we will be talking it right now. Hence, discussing a point, actually covering it up again. When I told you about deleting files, it do not get deleted, but instead it address on drive on which it saved is deleted. Almost similar thing happened to human brain. To understand it deeper, let's discuss an important point again. Talking of brain cells, data is stored in brain with help of neurons and connection between them. Remember the keyword connection between them, cause our brain always forms and breaks connection between neuron to highlight important points of memory. For now, for sake of simplicity, let's consider our simple neuron contain a piece of information, say as buying chili, and whenever your particular neuron is connected, you can't make any mistake regarding that. I am only asking you to consider it, because what actually happened, obviously no one knows. But what I know, that after consider the previous statement, many of you had already understood that we make mistakes. Why? But still we didn't get the key point, why computers don't make mistakes. And I know that some of you, especially those who had studied a little computer science, know why. And for those who don't, watch. Nay, listen. This is a small program, and every line you see is a function. And in layman language, you may say that each function has the smallest piece of work that computers do, and he can't do mistake in doing so. Many of you say that, well, what if it makes a mistake within that function? So how a person can make a mistake in stepping just one step forward? If he does, he is a dumbass. So coming to the point, computer actually follow a straight path, and each of his work is fixed. A proper program, say Windows, actually Windows is a program, Mac is a program, operating system is a program. So a proper program, say Windows, has million of these functions, and you may say that all these functions that is called is invoked somewhere, but the pattern of invoking of every function is fixed. So whenever this line of function is being called, then it cannot jump up to other. So for example, let's imagine the pattern is just straight down, and it actually is. The computer cannot skip a function until and unless it is asked to. So for example, first this line of function is called, then this. It never skips any function until and until we add another function to tell the flow to skip. I think that many of you haven't understood this yet, so consider it as an analogy and apply it to your life. So let me apply it to my life. So I was going to school. My first function that is called is going to school, and from going to school I just have to sit in the bus, and you know that we cannot make mistake in sitting into the bus. So we sit in the bus, that's our first function called. Then we reach the school, our second function will be called. We attend first class, one more function will be called. Then second class, one more function will be called. And as so on, our school ends and so-called 10th function may be called. Just say 10th function. And as the school ends, you are coming back home. The every step that you take, a function is called into your brain. But the only difference in our brain and computer is that computer has a specific flow, and until and unless a specific function is not applied, it will not skip any function. But our brain do not have a specific flow, hence it may skip any function if the subconscious mind seems irrelevant to it. Hence we can make mistakes while coming back home, and we can skip the function, so-called function in our brain, as buying chilies. And that's why our human brain makes mistake, just because a computer has a specific flow and our brains do not have. And from that specific flow, I mean that the pattern of calling the next function and then the next function and the next function. So these were the some reasons why we forget and why computers do not, and why we make mistakes and computers do not. The whole theory that you listen is written completely by me. Hence, if there is any mistake, then comment down below and share this video to your friends so that they can also know why computers don't forget and we humans do, and why computers don't make mistake and we humans do. I don't know how many times I repeat this statement. So please share this video and thumbs if you liked it, subs if you loved it, and also comment whose extra is this. Bye bye. There are very serious but epic storylines present in the current world. These are so intense and inspiring that it can even change particular mindset in terms of thinking and deciding tautology. This channel will help you in perceiving those storylines with family friendly streams. Currently, I am studying game development, so you will also be entertained by these vlogs, which I will upload after a couple of months. And as always,
thanks for watching.